Hi, welcome to Trading with TK, teaching you to turn ideas into money. We're at www.tradingwithtk.com, and it's Thursday, November 20th. And the market seems to be picking up some steam on the downside ever since it broke that support level 2 days ago. But that's typical. Once that triangle gets broken, it tends to accelerate on the downside. And I believe it's just beginning also. I said if we broke the low, that a new leg on the downside probably will incur. And, I mean, we're only 2 days into it, and we've already given up 600 points. Yes, we'll get our 200 and 300-point rallies back along the way, our little kickback rallies, but I do believe this leg has just begun, and I just don't know how far down. I'll make some comparisons to this break in relation to our last leg down. So we'll do that in our final segment when we take a look at all the indexes. I wouldn't be doing the market a fair judgment if I didn't mention what happened in Citicorp today. Citicorp in the last 2 days lost almost 45% of its value. The stock is trading around $5 a share. It's absolutely mind-boggling to see this corporation, the size of this, and how big it is around the world, and it's a huge money center bank, trading down at these levels that you start to wonder, are they in trouble too? Are they going to be in bankruptcy? I mean, $5 a share for Citicorp is just a frightening, frightening event. So if that's going to be the yardstick, if Citicorp stock can go to five, it doesn't speak well for the rest of the market. Unfortunately, for people who are long, it's not a good sign. And like I said, I do believe that this new break since we broke that low 2 days ago is just the beginning of another leg on the downside. So, I have another idea tomorrow. Another short idea. The stock is PENN. It's a casino stock. We'll take a look at that chart. I'll show you how I want to take that idea and turn it into some money. And then we'll also look at the indexes, and I'll show you some comparisons to what's going on now to what happened on the last break. So I'll be right back. All right, we're looking at a daily bar chart of PENN. Penn National Gaming Incorporated, and this is a call on the short side. We'll be looking to sell the stock short tomorrow, right around 1474 is where it closed, all the way up as high as 1560. So there's almost a dollar in there if we get a rally in the morning. If it breaks down early on, wait till it comes back up. It'll usually get back up somewhere within the yesterday's bar. But hopefully we get a little rally in the morning and we'll be able to get this short off somewhere up in here. Target on the downside is around the $9 area. Now I have to zoom out and turn it into a 9-day chart in order for you to see that. This support level right in here. Now this 9 is just an area. It could be 950, it could be 850, somewhere down in this area. I think the stock can get to this area before it tries to have another kickback rally. So it's a sort of a fluid number, but it kind of makes sense to me that this support area will hold it on the next pullback for the next kickback rally, and then eventually I think the stock's going to 5, but one trade at a time. So let's go back to the daily. And so we'll give you some more stats here. Buy stop would be a close above $17.21 right there. A close above that. What do I see? Well, kickback rally and now rolling over. So we've got a descending triangle formed, and you can see it broke that level, and then it broke that level, and I expect it to come all the way down here and break this level also. This is not going to be any kind of a support area. This will go through, it'll go through this like a hot knife through butter. All right, so let's recap this. This is PENN. This is a call on the short side. And when all's said and done, if it gets to 9, we could be making ourselves about $5 on the trade. Okay, let's go take a look at the major indexes, and I'll make some comparisons. It's about the only gauge that we're going to have to go by. Okay, this is a daily bar chart of the Dow, and today's Dow totally confirmed the breakdown. Now, this was our support level right there. And that's our triangle. Now that we've clearly penetrated that low, any rally back up to this line, anywhere around this line, is going to be our resistance area. Okay, but the comparison I want to make is how far down? What is it going to look like? Well, first thing we know is where our resistance area is. So if it should rally back up into this area, we know we have to be a seller. The only other guideline I have is this old break back here. Okay? We had our little descending triangle here. It broke, it kicked back into the triangle, and then it just totally collapsed. So, are we going to go down this much? We absolutely could, because a lot of times these charts turn out to be symmetrical. So I just don't know how far down we're going to go, but what we really need to know is direction mostly, and not how far. So that's about the only comparison I can make as to what we can expect here on the downside. Okay, let's move into some of the other indexes. Transportation average just extending its loss, down 4.5% today alone. So any kickback up into this area, this is going to be resistance. This will be our major resistance area, right there. And once again, this is about the only comparison I can make. This triangle here, when we broke, just totally collapsed. So, this is already extending itself pretty far down. And here we have the QQQs. We clearly broke the support level. We're clearly into another down leg. Any rally back up near this line here is would be an opportunity to sell, and we could be into something that looks like this again. Now, I can't go through all the averages tonight because I'm running out of time, and I only have 10 minutes. So that's my view of the market. The down leg continues until tomorrow. This is TK signing off.